God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Sounds nice. Okay. So algunos anuncios, some announcements. Next month, our next meeting for Corazón Puro is going to be October 21st. October when?
21st.
What date?
The 21st.
El día 11?
The
21st. The 11th? What happened? Y'all forgot the date already? October what? 21st. October what?
21st.
10/21. October 21st. El 21 de octubre es nuestra próxima reunión de Corazón Puro. We have the flyers in the back, so take some, bring somebody else next time. I hope everybody can come in to bring somebody else next time, please. Yo cumplí con mi comprometido de la reunión pasada, and I brought somebody else. Mi compromiso de la última vez, I brought somebody else, I brought my grandfather. Bring somebody else. Lo volante de la próxima reunión está allá, está detrás. También, for those of you who have received the ring, quien ha recibido su anillo de compromiso con el Señor. Ok, un aplauso a ellos. Praise the Lord. If you have received your ring, we know it's very difficult, we know it gets tough. Tú no estás solo, you're not alone. For the girls, we have a group, it's called Daughters of the Light. Odette's going to tell you a little bit more about it.
Oh, I wasn't going to talk about that, but... Adiós.
Buenas tardes, Daughters of the Light. Nuestra patrona es Santa Filomena. Y el nombre de Filomena en latín significa hija de la luz. Son nosotras, las muchachas de corazón puro, que tenemos el anillo de castidad. Nos estamos reuniendo para hablar, para comer. ¿Saben? Las muchachas siempre tenemos muchas cosas que hablar. Okay. So, lo único que tenemos que, la única cosa que nosotros le pedimos a las muchachas es que tengan su anillo de castidad. Vamos a hablar de todas esas cosas que le preocupan a las muchachas, todas esas preguntas que tienen, muchas cosas. La última, the last meeting that we had, we were in Catholic Underground and we had a great time. Estuvimos en el parque, we were having pizza, hablamos, y luego estuvimos juntas en Catholic Underground. And Felix, yo me acerqué a ti precisamente para pedirte que llamaras al padre Alberto, porque nosotros queremos escuchar un poco de lo que está pasando en Nicaragua. Y yo siempre lloro y lloro. No. Padre Alberto. Todo comienza con un deseo en el corazón de un ser humano. Podemos cambiar el mundo si quisiéramos. Llegamos a Nicaragua y muchos de los muchachos, más muchachos que muchachas, recibieron su anillo de castidad. Y yo lloraba. Bueno, y el padre Alberto estaba allá con nosotros y él se quedó encargado del grupo en Nicaragua. Y yo quisiera que él compartiera con nosotros un poco de qué está pasando en Nicaragua con Corazón Puro. ¿Qué está pasando en Nicaragua que podría pasar en México, en República Dominicana, en Puerto Rico, en tantos otros países, en Argentina, como nos están escribiendo? Corazón Puro quiere salir allá afuera. Por favor, ayúdenos. Aquí está el padre Alberto.
Señoras y señores, se los anuncia.
Fuerte aplauso, Padre Patrick, ya es sacerdote. Por favor. Who doesn't understand English? ¿Quién no habla inglés? No habla inglés. Preferiría en español. Maybe it's easier if I just go straight in English. ¿Qué piensa? Yes. Yes.
Yes.
30th of October this year, we celebrate 1 year of Corazón Puro in the Matagalpa, Nicaragua. And in fact, we are the friary of Convento San Antonio in Matagalpa. We thought, what is going to be our apostolate, you know? The Pandavida, U2000, or maybe this, maybe that. And so we are deciding for a long time what should be our focus, because there are so few of us and there is this much to do. What would be that one pearl? And we decided, okay, let's try Corazón Puro. And that was like one chispa, that was about one spark thrown into a bucket of supreme, was it a premium combustible gasoline? It just exploded. Corazón Puro, in fact, completely exploded. Just imagine this amount of people in a place three times smaller. Some people are squeezed, they're sitting on the floor. In fact, Brother Malachi, he said that we should build a second floor. In fact, we're going to move out from the friary because there are too many people coming and we cannot. And kids are coming from, some of them, they come from, you don't know, maybe, is there anyone here from Nicaragua? No. Wrong hand. Wrong person. But kids are poor, most of them poor kids, they travel on the bus, sometimes even for 40 minutes, just to be there. And our schedule is a little bit different, starts with, no, not so different. Starts with the holy hour, then we have charla, the talk, and then we finish with mass. So just to spread it a little bit, and surely confessions, and many, many, many people come from all kinds of Paso. And we, in fact, try to invite only the leaders. Because sometimes one group showed up, 60 people, and there were other 60 people, and there were other 60 people. So suddenly, you know, like sardines, like, could someone open the window, please? So we decided, please only the leaders or people who are important in the groups. And still, the room is completely filled. It's between 80 and 120 people every time we squeeze in the, you know, the room of this size. And the charlista presenting, so everything's like moving. So we have to move out. We will go to a different place. We started already, we have 11 people in a directiva in the helping us to, and I'm in charge of formation, so we meet twice a month, not for this, but just to form the formators. So we have 11 people in it. This is true, there are many young men interested, which is quite amazing. Usually it's the girls interested, because the like girls like relationships, and the guys like soccer and other stuff. Now, girls, they relationships, boys, they have partially relationships and partially other stuff. But it is true, in Nicaragua there are many, many young people interested. We have excellent team, 11 young kids, well-formed, going through the whole pretty much outline of theology of the body, Christian anthropology, and blah, 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 and other everything mishmash together, because we have to do it quickly. The 14th of October we have healing retreat for the directiva, and then in November, first weekend and second weekend, we'll have retreats for two different cities. One is from Sebaco, 54 people, and the other one is for Matagalpa, 80 some people. And this is only the leaders, and people are begging us, even from Managua, from the capital, come please. So we do small things. One day, in fact, in October, we have two small retreats for young people about amistades, friendships. Friendships with the same sex, friendships with opposite sex, and what the Bible says about the friendships. So we just try to also for younger kids, because we say in Matagalpa it's 15 years and up. We don't receive people who are younger than 15. But we'll try to do something corazoncito purito. Something for the chinguita stuff, for the small kids, on friendships, especially on friendships, no? Because things start before you get into trouble, you know, so you try to catch them and to show the beauty of friendships and respect all stuff. So we're starting that one also in October. Kemas, we need your help. How's that? We need your help. Even when you mentioned the anillos, our kids, we basically pay for the retreat. Our kids cannot pay for the retreat. They pay $5 for the whole weekend. Okay? And we pay. So basically, and it's really symbolic, it really covers nothing, and still we have to beg for food, we have to beg for anillos. We cannot really provide, for example, to buy anillos. I'm here, I arrived But before to beg money to buy it, we don't have money to buy it because friars, you know, also struggle with stuff. So if anyone, if he has, you know, if your boss is like this, in Nicaragua they show like this. It means you're rich. You know, like you have this much money. If you're this, you know, you can just skim a little bit, you know, and I'm asking for help. If anyone, if he feels that you could help in any way, any form, I know it's not the time to beg, but you know what? Because it's not the situation over there. We live in the second poorest country in the Western Hemisphere, and our kids cannot really pay for a trip. So we have to pay them, we have to help them in t-shirts, anillos. They could never afford any of it. Even to pay for the food for 3 days, our kids could not pay. So we have to pay for them. But it's worth it, and it's worth it. And whatever you can help, or someone that you know that is and can help, let us know. Yeah, there is a table, there are people whom you know, maybe just write your name or something, or a check maybe, or something. That's our difficulty. Transportation, you know, people just all over, you know, there are like 50 people in a pickup truck. I mean, you would have to, that's how we share people, you know. It's not like, please fasten your seatbelts. Like, please fasten yourself to the roof of the pickup truck, because it's, you know, we're sitting on the sack of onions, it's about to go to the tree. So, sure, but I have to tell you, kids are absolutely, and we have people in our directiva, they're 16, 17, 18 years old, 19. They go to their schools and they just recently got into trouble because they decided to say something about abortion. So, no, 16, the girls like fireballs. Said, no, that's all lie. You know, they stand up in the school, they contest on those the professors. And then, now they spread the message, and all I can say is fire is spreading all over Nicaragua. Fire is spreading, started in Honduras, I'm not sure how it is in Honduras, but Nicaragua is spreading so quickly. So many institutions are asking us to come and help to end it. They say, algo, anything, one bomb, anything, because people, it's such a great desire. And people, in Nicaragua, people are so receptive. Young people just unbelievable. I tell you, people, I'm impressed. Amen?
Amen.
If you can help you in any way, if you like dreams to be a filmmaker in Nicaragua, or what else? Y tenemos ahí dicen porra o shout out es esperar a Dios seguro, los de corazón puro, which is Matthew 5:8. Those who of pure heart will see God. Verán a Dios seguro, los de corazón puro. Amen. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Padre Alberto. Just so you know that it's not just here, that Corazón Puro is in other places, and that this message is needed in other places, no solamente para nosotros, pero que jóvenes just like us, and other places that need this message, amen?
Amen?
So, it is our job, each and every single one of us here, to take the message, to start putting that grain of sand, empezar a llevar ese granito de arena para también nosotros llevar el mensaje, amen?
Amen.
So, I shall continue. As I continue with the announcements, we have our brothers and sisters over here with the baskets, los modelos de corazón puro. Van a pasar con las canastas, como ustedes saben, nosotros dependemos, just like Father was saying, we depend on your donations, dependemos de sus donaciones, para poder seguir reuniéndonos para la comida que se come. También tenemos allá en la mesa, allá está en cosas de ventas, y la librería de Corazón Puro ya está. We have our bookstore back there, we have t-shirts, so you can pass by the table and be generous for whatever God asks you to do, amen? Amen? Lo que el Señor te pida que des. So we shall continue with the announcement. So when is the next Corazón Puro meeting again? I forgot. October 21st. Excuse me. So for the ladies that have received the ring, para las damas, las jóvenes que han recibido su anillo, pónganse en contacto con él y ella le dará más información acerca de todos los otros ahí, las hijas de la luz. Amén. Okay, so for the gentlemen, I'm going to invite my brother Chris. He's going to tell you a little bit about our gentlemen's group, for those gentlemen that have received the ring. Amen?
Oras y bendiciones a todos. Nosotros, yo y unos más hermanos de corazón puro, comenzamos el grupo Hombres para Cristo. Y brevemente nosotros nada más queremos enfocarnos a 6 cosas para Cristo. Y en este grupo, un grupo de formación, un grupo de saber quién es, como Padre estaba diciendo arriba, quién tú eres en Cristo, qué Cristo quiere que tú hagas en tu vida para Él. Básicamente eso, y nosotros vamos a orar, leer la Biblia, estudiar la Biblia y hacer actos de penitencia también. So, a todos los hombres, all the young guys out there that have the ring, please join us. We have a set location for right now. It's Our Savior Church. It's here in the Bronx, right on the other side of the Bronx. The address is 20, well, I don't. If you have a question of where exactly it is, just come to me later. Si tiene una pregunta de donde sea que quiere, a dónde está la parte, venga de mí. Ya tenemos un lugar que los reunimos los lunes a las 7. Muchas gracias y pasen buena noche.
Amen. Thank you, Chris. Okay. So everything has been very important, pero una de las cosas más importantes that keeps Corazón Puro going, not just here, but in Nicaragua and Honduras and everywhere that Corazón Puro has started, it's prayer. Amen? Yeah. Esa es una de las cosas más importantes, la oración, que mantiene a Corazón Puro siguiendo hacia adelante. And so we have a prayer night every week. Tenemos una noche de oración todas las semanas. Es los miércoles. Amén. Entonces, un miércoles es en la Catedral de San Patricio, St. Patrick's Cathedral. We will meet for Mass at 5:30 and then for adoration after Mass. So, algunos miércoles suceden en la Catedral de San Patricio, nos reunimos para misa y luego adoración. Los otros miércoles, se alternan los miércoles. Los otros miércoles suceden en la Capilla de Santa Filomena. It's in Queens, in Woodside. If you need further information, it's in the back of the flyer. So the next meeting is in St. Patrick's, if you're around and you can make it. Mass starts at 5:30. It will be September 19th, October 3rd, and October 17th. The information is in the back of the flyer. Amen?
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 Amen.
Y para St. Philomena's Chapel in Woodside, Queens, is at 6:30, and it will be September 26th, October 10th, and October 24th. So check out the flyers, and we also have a website, so you can use it to spread the word. It's corazonpuro.org. Also, if you have any questions about chastity, about living the lifestyle, you need advice, whatever it is, just put it on the website and you'll get an answer as soon as we get to it. Amen? And there's articles also that might give you the answer even before you write out your questions. So check them out. Hay artículos también en el website que tenemos. Lo pueden revisar, lo pueden leer. Tal vez alguna pregunta que tú tienes respuesta en ese artículo. Amen? So you're welcome to check it out, and we shall continue. Amen. So when is the meeting? Next meeting, Corazón Puro?
October
21st. What? October 12th?
No.
Oh, okay. Somebody needs to remind me, so I'm gonna start asking people to just remind me when the next meeting is, because I'm gonna forget. Okay. So ahora vamos a la parte. Padre Alberto has something to share.
I need to go to. Corazón Puro, pura Nica todavía. Prefiero polaco. Todavía no tenemos la página web. Pero si ustedes van a ir a Facebook, Corazón Puro Nica, N-I-C-A. You can find the pictures, you can find movies, you can find what we do in our formation. Just also support the Hey Kids, we are with you. You know, because they are. Many of them are really pro kids. They're completely in love with Jesus. They do amazing stuff. The best-selling book in the Diocese of Matagalpa, you know what it is? Amor Puro. It's the best-selling. We have rights to print that book in Nicaragua. Also, Pure Femininity and Masculinity. Amor Puro is like... We make no profit because... But that was part of the right, not to make profit, but... People at schools, it's really amazing. It's spreading like fire.
Praise the Lord. Un aplauso. So now we shall move on to the next part of Corazón Puro. So vamos a continuar con esta reunión y vamos a continuar la próxima parte de nuestra reunión, que es el tema de hoy. Amén. And the person who will be sharing this tema with you guys today, and girls, is Julissa. So Julissa is going to come share with us the message for tonight. Amen. And if we can all stand up and extend our hands to Julissa. Empezamos en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Amén. Señor Dios Padre, Señor Dios Hijo, Espíritu Santo, te pedimos y te damos gracias por las palabras que has puesto en Julissa. We give you thanks and we ask of you to continue to guide her, to continue to align her with your wisdom, Lord. Que tu sabiduría sea lo que nosotros recibamos esta noche a través del mensaje que tú has puesto en ella, Señor Jesús, that we may live freely the way that you have called us to live, Lord. We ask all of this through the intercession of the most precious Blessed Mother, as we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Our Lady of Guadalupe, pray for us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. Amen. How are you guys feeling?
Great.
Great, blessed, good. Who's tired? Oh, no, come on. You guys are blessed. You guys are beautifully blessed because you are here today and you're glowing. God has a specific message for each and every one of you. So, like I said, my name is Julissa Maria Espinal Esteves Durán. But I'm here to give us certain, a message that the Lord has been putting in my heart for quite some time now. And I'm very happy that he's sharing it. So, it's living the good life, okay? But not living the good life, living the good and free life, which is a huge difference. Amen. How many first-timers do we have here? First-timers. Okay, praise the Lord. Praise.
Yes.
Amen. Give it up. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Welcome. Well, God is good because according to the topic, it's according to, if you guys have been coming to Corazón Puro, you've been receiving certain messages. Ay, estoy hablando en inglés, perdón. Tengo que hablar español también. Gracias. Okay, that was the Holy Spirit, nobody gave me something. So, you're supposed to live out this life. Hay que vivir esta vida. No solamente sentar y escuchar. It's not only to sit and to listen to, which is great to hear and to get the knowledge, but what good is it if there's nothing being done about it? What good is it if you're not living it? O sea, ¿cuál es el propósito si uno está sentado, escuchando, entendiendo y captando, pero no está caminando a hacer lo que el Señor te ha mandado a hacer? And it was funny because I didn't even know, but during the gospel, during the readings today, we have the second reading. Who remembers la segunda lectura de hoy? Second reading. What was it about? What was that on? Faith without works is dead. I was like, damn, Holy Spirit, you are on it. I didn't even know that. But it's true. I was like, this is exciting. Okay, Holy Spirit, we're there. Because el Señor dice que si tú entiendes y sabes y tienes la fe y conoces muy bien, pero no hay acción, there's no action, there's no deed, it's dead. ¿Para qué sirve? Might as well not have come if you're going to just live the same life. What's the point? And God is calling us to be the difference, to be a change. Entonces, el Señor, ¿cuál es el punto? Como dijo la palabra en Santiago, en la segunda lectura, dijo que fe sin trabajos es
muerto.
¿Cuál es el propósito de venir si tú no vas a dedicarte a vivir esta vida? Because it's not easy. It's not easy. All of us that have the ring, I think we could say, it ain't easy. It's not just about, oh, voy a Corazón Puro tres veces, I'm getting my ring. No. It's like, oh man, this is coming up. I gotta decide, I gotta really live this. This is hard, man. Y pesa to live it. Because there are obstacles that don't want us to live freely, that want us changed back. Why do you think that? Why do you think they want us to change back? Especially the enemigo que siempre ataca. because he's afraid of who you are meant to be. He's afraid if you recognize who you're called to be. And what are we called to be? Holy. We're called to be holy. Man, the power of holiness. Amen. And holiness ain't something like, I love it because recently I was watching this documentary of Mother Teresa. And man, come on, Mother Teresa, who loves Mother Teresa? Okay, praise the Lord. You gotta be like, well, snap or something, Mother Teresa. Anyway, I didn't know too much about her, believe it or not. I just know that una vez, perdón, yo estaba diciendo que Madre Teresa, estaba viendo un documentario acerca de Madre Teresa. And it was beautiful because I didn't know much about her. And I was just like, all I knew is that my dad met her once and got these medals and that's it. But I was like, I don't really know much about her, that's it. And I started really digging into her life and what she did. In una entrevista, in an interview, they asked, Mother Teresa, they're calling you the living saint of the 20th century. Hey, Madre Teresa, tú eres la santa de esta generación. What do you think of that? ¿Qué tú crees? And I love her because she's like, I'm called to be holy in my state of life. You called to be holy in your state of life. It's like, there's nothing extraordinary. We're called to be holy. And I was like, yo, that's it. Like, entonces, Madre Teresa dijo, básicamente le preguntaron, tú vas a ser la santa de esta generación, ¿qué tú crees de eso? Ella dice, no hay gran cosa, yo estoy llamada a ser santa, en su acento, tú sabes que ella tenía. Yo estoy llamada a ser santa en mi estado de vida, tú estás llamada a ser santo en tu estado de vida, no es nada extraordinario, o sea, estamos llamados a hacer eso. So like, that's the call to ordinary life, to be holy. Like, think about that. You are, the ordinary way of life should be holiness. And a lot of us, when we think of holiness, we're like, oh, I ain't there, I'm not here. I mean, of course, we're on our way there, but it's almost as if it's such a far reach, like I'm never gonna get there. And God's like, well, you're called for that, believe it or not. And it's possible, I will give you the grace. And all is grace, thanks be to God. Anything is grace. And so he calls us with a purpose. And it's beautiful because it's like a little diagram or a little map. No tiene un propósito, es como un mapa, una guía. Vamos a empezar desde el principio, el propósito del hombre y de la mujer. Like, from the beginning, the purpose of man, you know? First step. Think of it like a start, then like a map, like you try to map it and then an end, okay? That's the picture, all right? I can't put that on a PowerPoint because that's kind of hard. But it's okay, you got a mind. So you have to start. You recognize that you are created in the image and likeness of
God.
Tú estás creado en la imagen y semejanza de
Dios.
De Dios. Si tú no reconoces eso, ese es el primer punto. El Señor quiere que tú conozcas que you are meant for something. You have a mission, and He has a purpose for you. If you don't recognize and don't believe that, man, you can't even step out of the little wall, you know, in your little maze. Like, you have to believe that. Creer que tu vida es sagrada. Que tu vida tiene dignidad. To know that your life is sacred. And your life in itself has dignity. To believe that. Once you believe that about yourself, you're able to move on. You're able to love. Which is the next part. So, once you know, tú eres especial para el Señor tiene un propósito para ti. Cuando tú lo crees, no lo creas, pero lo crees en tu corazón, uno puede seguir el próximo paso. And so you go on the path, a path to our destination. What's the path? Who wants to guess? After you know and you love yourself, and you know you love God, what's the next path?
Others.
Amen. Yeah, on point. Who's up? Good. El Señor te está llamando a amar a tu prójimo. Pero no estoy diciendo como amar, como que, oh man, I love this car. You know, I love this book. I love this pen. I love you. No. That's like, you, mira, hasta en la oración yo he sentido eso, que yo siempre digo, oh, te amo, Señor. And mi corazón es like, where are the deeds? And I'm like, oh. I'm just saying I love you though, okay? No, you have to, you know, do. And you do by loving your neighbor. And Of course, we'll go through the corporal works of mercy and all these things. But to love one another, especially, I always have Mother Teresa. You know, she literally went to the poor and just like fed them. One of the girls in the house, every time I live in a Hesed discernment, and when we're driving in the back, she always has a box of granola bars. Box of granola bars, she always has. And sometimes I'm hungry and I want to eat it, you know, but that's not what